Let us calculate gravitational field strength due to a point mass, say we are having a point mass m. Then as we have already studied that in its surrounding region there exists a gravitational field, now in this situation at a distance x from the point mass. If we are having a point p, and we place a test mass m not over here. In this situation this mass m will exert a force F according to Newton's law of gravitation on m naught, which is given as g m m naught by x square. This x can be written as position vector of point P. So in this situation we can write gravitational field strength at P due to point mass m is. We can state that this force is acting on m naught, because m naught is placed in the gravitational field of this point mass m. So gravitational field at point P due to point mass m can be written as gp, and this gp we can write as F by m naught, and its magnitude will be, on substituting the values, it is gm by x square. Here m naught get cancelled out, and if we wish to write it vectorially, then vectorially it can be written as gp vector is equal to, as the direction of force is towards the point mass m. So it is exactly opposite to the vector x, so it is written as negative of gm by x square x cap. Or it can be written as negative of gm by x cube into x vector. In this way we can write the gravitational field vectorially at a point in the surrounding of a point mass m. Also remember that result will be the basic rule by which we can find the gravitational field due to extended bodies. Also, let's also discuss that. In continuation we can discuss gravitational field strength due to extended bodies, say, if we are having an extended body of mass m. As we have discussed that every mass creates a gravitational field in its surrounding. In its surrounding also there exists a gravitational field, and say there exists a point P in the surrounding and we wish to find out the gravitational field strength at point P. Then, we can consider an elemental mass dm in it, and say, with respect to point P, dm is located at a position vector r. Then due to dm at point P we can say, gravitational field dg will exist in direction towards dm. So in this situation we can write gravitational field strength at P due to dm is, this dg vector can be written as dg vector is along the direction of position vector of this elemental mass dm. This can be written as g dm by r cube into r vector. And if we wish to find the gravitational field strength at P due to whole body is, this can be written as g at point P vector is integration of dg vector. As we are taking a general case, we only integrate the expression which is gdm by r cube multiplied by r vector, which is for the integration of the whole body m. But if some symmetry or dimension of the body is given, if the body is symmetric or dimensions of the body are given, in that case, we don't apply the vector integration. We can resolve this elemental gravitational field strength due to dm in different directions like x or y direction and integrate them separately. We will see some applications of calculations of gravitational field strength in next sections. With that it will be more clear that how we calculate this mathematically rather than by directly using this expression for vector integration.